Can it get any better than this? Almost not. We are in the most auspicious groove right now, and I don't have work, but this gives the opportunity to continue on in this tremendously auspicious groove. Everyone is seeking refuge from the universe. We all are, okay, but very few are finding it, all right? But we are closing in on refuge. This is how I feel. That's how auspicious it is. And it is developing, it is continuing to develop, so I am going to continue to lay it out here for everybody to listen to and absorb. So, if we take a moment to center ourselves in the basic discipline here. Very exciting, though. Very exciting. And I left off last night with a video talking about I am total, complete failure. I am total, complete failure. I am total, complete failure. And went to bed, and this is just this huge wow, this buzzing. And then this morning I woke up and I continued to advance that. And I was able to advance it. It's getting better. It's getting better. The universe is just a pathetic, quaint, whimsical wannabe in terms of failure. It's trying to generate failure, but it's utterly inept. You know, it's completely inept at it. It's a mockery, a parody. But I am perfect failure. I am perfect failure. I am absolute, total, complete, perfect failure, without even a ripple of success upon this endless ocean, this endless, still, calm ocean of perfect failure. There's not even a ripple of success on that ocean. And everything that the universe is doing in trying to compete with it, you know, doesn't touch it, doesn't even touch it. Death doesn't even touch this failure. It doesn't even touch this failure. Decay does not even touch this failure. This is perfect failure. This is perfect failure. Absolute, total, complete, perfect failure. I am that. I am that. I am that. The universe is not a perfect failure. It's a ridiculous jumble of like success and failure, right? It's a ridiculous jumble of success and failure. Yet what we are is perfect failure, without even a ripple of success, not even a tremor of success. All the death and decay that the universe is trying to, you know, pile up here doesn't even touch I am perfect failure. Passes it right by. Total sanctuary. Nothing the universe does can touch this perfect failure. Now, of course, this is a way to conceptualize it, right? Ultimately, reality is inherently free of all conceptualization. But from the standpoint of where we're at right now, we have to conceptualize it at this where we're at right now. So I find the best way to conceptualize it is this total, absolute, total, complete, perfect failure. Perfect failure. Okay. And the universe cannot reach this. It cannot touch it. It cannot touch it. It's as if there was some sort of glass ceiling above this, and all the ways that the universe tries to generate failure doesn't even get through that glass ceiling at all. You're beneath that in this absolute perfect stillness and calm. And all of the efforts of the universe to generate failure, they're just quaint whimsicality. You know, it's absolutely constantly enmeshed with success and dualistic success and failure. It cannot, the universe is completely dualistic. Okay, it cannot touch the absolute, total, complete, perfect failure that we inherently are. I am total, absolutely total, complete, perfect failure without even a hint of success anywhere. Not even a trace of success can be found. Okay. So, I am finding that this is the best way to conceptualize the situation, the best way to approach it through your ideas, concepts, thoughts, etc., and feeling is this perfection, absolute perfect failure. Right? Failure to succeed in changing what we are, right? So, don't try to mix it up too much. If you do, be very clear. You can say, I am absolute, total, perfect, absolute, total, complete, perfect failure. And I walk with God in perfect holiness. I walk with God in perfect holiness. Perfect holiness. Okay. But the trouble comes when we try to conceptualize holiness or anything at all about reality in positive terms. Because positive terms automatically we associate them with success in the sense of the universe or what the purpose of the universe is. Automatically we do. You see, we're trying to successfully change reality. This is what we view as success. So as soon as we start talking in positives, we run into this very severe problem. So it's way better to speak in terms of negatives and be grounded in that. And then you can add on the positive on that foundation of perfect failure. Perfect failure. Perfect failure. From what I'm feeling, the ego cannot deal with this. The universe cannot get a hold of the perfect failure at all. You've successfully escaped the universe. What a tremendous positive. Perfect failure is the ultimate positive. Absolutely it is. The universe cannot. You've escaped. We've escaped the universe, which is what we're trying to do, of course. Can't touch us. Not even the atoms can touch us. The electrons, nothing. I'm perfect failure. I am perfect failure. Not a single instance of success has ever touched this perfect failure. It's never been touched by any success. Never. And so there's just this endless, seamless domain of perfect failure. Perfect failure. So as long as we're talking in terms of positives, the ego has got us and said, yeah, I understand success too, you know, and we can work together on success. And this then leaves you very vulnerable to the Eve deception, which is all about saying that we can be successful. The egoic Eve deception, we can be successful in changing reality. Just prove to arrogance that it's not arrogant. But when we talk in terms of this absolute negative, absolute failure, yes, I am an absolute perfect failure. The ego can't touch that. It cannot touch that. So it's presenting these ridiculous parodies of failure, like death, you know, that's like some little plastic trinket. Decay, you know, what a joke. What a joke to present decay as absolute, perfect, total, complete failure, or death, or all this nonsense that the universe is presenting as if it's some failure wannabe. You know, the universe is just some has-been wannabe trying to ape, you know, failure, but totally coming up short in that. It can't help but try and throw in success in there. But we can take refuge in absolute, total, complete, perfect failure. I am an absolute, total, complete, perfect failure. I am absolute, total, complete, perfect failure. I am perfect failure without even a ripple of success, not even this tiniest breeze of success. Absolute stillness. It's never been touched by success. Where I live, it's never been touched by success. Success has never touched it, not even come close to touching it. No trace of it. So this is actually tremendous news. This is very exciting to get to this now. And I'm just absorbing this and going with it and feeling very positive about it. It's like, wow, yeah, wonderful. But of course, to the ego, this is terrible. This is like, well, what do you mean? You need success. I said, no, I don't need any success. I just need to abide in absolute perfect failure. Abide in the perfection of this absolute perfect failure. No trace of success at all. So I'm finding that this is the anchor, you know, that we need. And we're breaking the ice on this, is what we're doing here. We're breaking the ice on this. This is not something you can sit around waiting for the ego to present to you, the universe to present to you. It'll never present. The universe will never present this to you. There will be those who appear in the universe who can present this to you, but the universe itself can never present this to you. The ego can never present this to you. Only the grace of God can present this to you. To us. I am perfect failure. I rest in perfect failure. I abide in perfect failure. I take refuge in perfect failure. I take refuge in perfect failure. So as far as the intensity of this, the difficulty, well, certainly it's strong, but I got a good night's sleep last night, and I feel okay. It's like a sort of a deep ache, sort of a deep, dull ache as you're shedding these concepts of success. All the positive concepts, because all concepts are derived from the attempt to change reality. All of them. Even the positive ones. Especially the positive ones, actually. So we wonder, we spent all our life trying to, you know, say, oh, yes, I'm holy, yes, I'm good, yes, I'm this, yes, yes, I'm trying to, we're trying to be successful. Nobody succeeds, right? Really? No. Because we're going about in the wrong way. The ego's way, the universe's way. We think we need to successfully integrate with the universe. No, we don't. We need to escape the universe entirely. Take refuge from it. Find a sanctuary from it. And we find sanctuary from it in perfect failure. Perfect failure. The universe is just like a silly little child playing in a sandbox, building ridiculous little sand castles. And, you know, it's a failure at failure. It's an absolute failure at failure. It can't succeed at failure. I am perfect failure. I am perfect failure. I am perfect failure. Flawless, perfect failure. I am flawless, perfect failure. The best the universe can do is just symbolize failure. That's all it can do. Decay, death, just symbolizing failure. But I am perfect failure. Perfect failure. Nothing has ever strayed from this perfect failure. And I walk with God in perfect holiness. Perfect holiness. Totally whole, right? No seams. No flaws, absolute perfection, absolute perfection. I experience the absolute perfection of this total, complete, perfect failure. And of course, we're doing this as practice, aren't we? Instead of discussion. There's no discussion here. All of these videos are invitation to practice. That's all that they are. Invitation to practice. No discussion. This is perfect failure here. We are practicing this perfect failure, this notion, we're getting used to this, like, wow, there is a way to escape the universe, isn't there? And if you're honest about it, you realize this is the escape from the universe, absolutely. Now, people can argue as long as they want about, well, should we escape the universe or et cetera like that. Well, that's a different issue. We know intuitively, absolutely, we must escape the universe. So if you accept that as a basic premise, then there's no argument that perfect failure is the escape from the universe. The universe is just saying, well, I'm good failure too. I'm perfect failure. No, it's not. It's completely, totally dualistic, mixed in with success. The universe can't get out of its own way at all. Absolutely cannot. It just symbolizes it and throws a bunch of boasting about it, but we absolutely want to escape the universe. So just to be able to speak of this and look at it and practice it, it is just an enormous, they call it historic, it's even beyond historic. Every day the newspapers, whatever, they're historic this, historic that, historic. History was made today. You know? Well, this is beyond history. This is beyond making history. This is perfect failure. This is perfect failure to make any history at all. I am perfect failure to make any history at all. I don't make even a speck of history. I completely fail to make any history. In fact, I haven't even made any time at all. I've completely failed at that. I'm a complete failure. I'm a total, perfect, complete failure. How awesome is that? That is great. I am a total, complete, perfect failure. I failed to make any history at all. I failed to make any time at all. I failed to make any success at all. I'm a perfect failure. The universe can't be a perfect anything, can it? But I'm a perfect failure. Obviously, there's this inner excitement about this. It's just, is wow. The wow is just, can't even measure it. It's just, don't ever try to measure the wow. That's the whole idea, is the wow has gone beyond measurable limits. When it goes beyond measurable limits, that's where you feel the wow. As long as you think you can measure it and contain it, it's not a wow. When it goes beyond, wow, this is just off the charts. That's the wow. And this is just, the wow is just like continually flowing. Just beyond anything. Perfect failure. Wow. I've never made even the slightest bit of success. Never made history. Never made time. Never even made space. I'm such a complete failure. I've never even made space. I'm such a total complete perfect failure. I've never even made any process. No process. Never made any form. I'm such a failure, I can't even make any form. Perfect failure. No time, no space, no process, no form. I'm not even generated any of that. I completely failed to generate any of that. Perfect failure. So rejoice, rejoice, and rejoice in your perfection. We have found perfection, and we found perfection in failure. Perfect failure. The one place the ego never looks, and cannot look there. It's all enmeshed in dualistic attempts at success. It's trying to succeed. How can it abide in perfect failure? How can that which is in dedicated to success, how can it abide in perfect failure? It cannot. They'll say, oh, yeah, there's some failure. I got good failure, too. I got death, you know. Yeah, but how can you have death if you don't first have life, right? Yeah, first have bodies, right, in order for them to die. You can't succeed at death unless you succeeded at life, too, huh? So you can't, that's not a perfect failure. What about decay? You have to have something to succeed at growing in order to have some decay. You see? It's completely dualistic. You're not a perfect failure, ego. You'll never be a perfect failure. You will never be a perfect failure. The universe will never be a perfect failure. Now, in hearing this, it's a shock. Absolutely, it's a shock. But we're doing spiritual shock treatment for those who are desperate to take refuge. Absolutely. Everyone really wants to take refuge in the universe, but some are truly desperate because they realize that the universe is no friend of theirs at all. Not a friend at all. It's a vicious taskmaster, absolutely vicious, merciless. Doesn't matter how much lipstick you put on that pig, it's still vicious. Got a massive lipstick campaign going on in the world, and it doesn't matter how much lipstick you put on a pig, it's still a pig. Put all the lipstick you want on the universe, it's still ridiculous. Completely dualistic, completely vicious, completely abysmal, and can't get out of its own way. Can never be a perfect failure. The universe can never be a perfect failure. What a joke. What a joke. It's just a bad joke. The universe is just a bad joke. It's always struggling. I want to be a perfect failure, but I can't succeed at that. You know, I can't succeed at that. The success keeps getting in my way. It keeps getting my... That's all it is. It's a bad joke. It just stumbles around. Just stumbles around. It will never be perfect failure. Cannot be. We're inherent perfect failures. Created that way. Perfect, absolutely perfect failures. Can never ever succeed in any way. Completely free of any notion of success. Incapable of success. Yeah, I am perfectly incapable of success. Perfectly incapable. Totally, completely, perfectly incapable of any success whatsoever. That is what I am. And I abide in what I am. I take refuge in what I am. So the shock of this, that's part of the medicine that we have to take. Right? This is just, you got to take your medicine. We have been trying to succeed so desperately for so long, trying to believe that we can change what we are, that this familiarity and continuity and all this seems like a barrier, but it's just this medicine of you feel like shocked, stunned, wow, this is just, you know, and the ego says, whoa, I can give you a wow here, take this drug, sex, drugs, rock and roll, come on. And you say, nah, ego, that's not the real wow. Not at all. This wow's way better. Way more intense. And steady, I can keep going back to it. You know, it's just, I'm in control of it. It's great. I'm a total, complete failure. I'm completely incapable of any success. So this truly turns the tables on the universe, on the ego, on our hideous detour into fear. This is truly flips the script, completely flips the script. And initially it will feel shocking, but I'm testing it out on myself, and it's not too bad. It's strong, absolutely it's strong. It's strong medicine. So you don't have to be, no one has to be engaged in this lipstick campaign. We can take refuge from the universe. That's our option. It's either one or the other, right? You know, you can be frantically chasing pigs, catching them, putting a lipstick on them. Hey, you look great. Let me put some eyeshadow too. Let me dress you up, pig. Put some, and catch and release, chasing another pig. Let me put lipstick on this one. It's a lipstick campaign. Nobody has to do that. We can take refuge from the universe. Who doesn't want to take refuge from the universe? Who doesn't want to take refuge? Does anyone believe the ego's lies that we can be special? We can have a special place in the universe? That's going to make us happy? That will make us, we'll be satisfied with a special, well, you're a special lipstick applier, you know, you're special, so you should be happy then. Does anyone really believe that? Nobody really trusts the universe. Nobody believes, everyone wants to escape the universe. They're just not sure how to do it. They're just, and this is the trouble we have. And the trouble is when we try to say, well, I'm almost a perfect failure, not quite. This is still the universe. We're still hooked into it then. And we have to accept perfect failure. Without one exception, no exceptions. This is the whole key. This is what Jesus has been telling us and telling us and telling us. For example, in A Course in Miracles, Journey Beyond Words, no exception, no exception. He says it may seem difficult, but it really isn't, really isn't. The difficulty comes when we try to make an exception. That's where the difficulty comes from. But just decide no exception, and it's easy. I'm absolute perfect failure without any exception. I'm incapable of success. I am totally incapable of success. I've never been capable of it. I've never experienced success. I've always been dwelling. Always my home. I cannot leave my home of perfect failure. There's nowhere else to go. I can never succeed in leaving my home of perfect failure because I'm perfect failure. There can't be any success there. My home doesn't have any success whatsoever. And I walk with God in perfect holiness, in this absolute perfection of perfect failure. And deep down we realize this works, and we will take refuge from the universe, and we're saying like, wow, this is like pretty big deal. Well, actually the universe, what is the universe? It's just a silly, quaint, whimsical dream is all. Something to be chuckled over for a little bit, and that's it. So, I mean, it's not that big of a deal. We shouldn't be awed by it. I am absolute perfect failure. How can I say this? How can we listen to this? How can we? Well, thanks to Jesus, thanks to the other ones who have witnessed to this absolute perfect failure. Flawless perfect failure here in this world. You can see that it's possible. And you can still function here. You can see that. So we can take refuge. So those who have taken refuge, thanks to them, were able to give this proper consideration and acceptance. Without them, it would be prohibitively difficult, actually. The ego's frantically trying to eliminate any traces of perfect failure here in the world, and as it pursues this lipstick culture. Lipstick campaign. cliff strip culture is an iron curtain designed to prevent anyone from taking refuge from the universe, actually. And yet we cannot be stopped. We cannot be stopped because we're accepting sanctuary in perfect failure. The sanctuary is there, and the ego cannot prevent it. So we accept sanctuary in the realm of perfect failure. Now, those who want to take sanctuary, they may equivocate for a while, okay? And that's where those who are able to encourage, they, you know, say, oh, okay, it's okay, equivocate, but don't spend too much time. Let's practice instead of equivocating. Let the equivocating be seen as just the wow, okay? And don't struggle with it. The universe is saying, you must choose success. We can succeed. Yes, we can succeed. We can change reality. You must choose success. We say, no, we're taking refuge in perfect failure. Perfect failure. So we can take refuge from this lipstick culture. Absolutely. And there are those who did take refuge in this perfect failure. Absolutely. And the universe couldn't touch them. Could not touch them, actually. Their sanctuary remained untouched by success. So this, again, let the equivocation be just a wow feeling and don't struggle with it. Just full stop in this wow feeling. Just accept it. This is the price we have to pay for our folly, you know, trying to leave our home of perfect failure. This is the price we pay. But it's a small price to just feel this. Now, you cannot force anybody to take refuge, and so you just have to take refuge yourself, and then the grace of God will attract those who truly want to take refuge. You cannot force it upon someone. Say, oh, I think refuge would be really good for you, and if they don't want to take refuge, if they want to keep participating in this lipstick culture, then that's what they'll do. That's okay. That doesn't change your perfect failure at all. Perfect failure remains perfect failure, no matter who tries to, you know, dabble in success thinking. Doesn't matter. Eventually, everyone will take refuge from this universe. Absolutely. this feeling of, wow, the ego's confounded by this. You see, it's absolutely confounded. So it might feel very confounded, but this is just, let it be the wow, because mixed in that is elation. You know, you realize this is it. This is it. So, of course, within, I'm very elated. But I'm also, you know, keeping this just steadiness and just letting it express as wow. This just sort of formless wow. Don't put any other words to it. This is just, if you use just one word, just wow. That's it. It doesn't go any further than that. Like a gold miner keeps picking into the face of this cliff or rock, and they've been looking for the mother lode, and they finally chip some rock off, some quartzite or something, and they see this gold there, and they chip some more. There's more gold. Chip some more, and they're looking in, and they see it's like it's just a vein, and they can see, you know, and just like gradually starts dawning upon them that they've hit the mother lode. That this face of rock just covering this pure mountain of gold, actually, and it starts dawning upon the miner who's been looking for this gold for so long. And they just have to, you know, stop for a little bit picking and just sit there and just perfect failure, incapable of success, absolute gold, the absolute gold of perfect failure. It's been found, it's been located. California was founded on the belief that the hills were full of gold. That's why I call it the Golden State. That's why people came here. We expected we'd hit the mother lode, the ultimate, you know, we'd reach pure gold. But we didn't realize that the pure gold comes from perfect failure. So, we found the gold here. It just wasn't the gold that we were looking for initially, right? We were looking for success. We didn't realize that what we really want is perfect failure. That can never be touched by success. Success can never touch it. And of course, we're not going to run out in the public marketplace and scream to everybody, I'm a perfect failure, I'm a perfect failure, you know. at least not yet. What I've found is almost everyone here is trying to take refuge in imperfect failure. Say, yeah, I can fail too, but it's imperfect, you know. These ridiculous illnesses we have, depressions, sicknesses, mental disease, mental illness, deaths. This is ridiculous. You know, we're trying to take refuge in an imperfect failure. What a joke. What a joke all this is. I tried to take refuge in all this, you know, severe depression. Didn't work. Because it wasn't perfect failure. You see? When you take refuge in perfect failure, you give up death, sickness, depression, misery, sickness, infirmities, all this nonsense. These are like wannabe failures, you know. Fake failures. You give up all these fake failures. Those are just fake. All these lipstick failures. Because it's all actually still based on a premise, a foundation of seeking success. See? That's why it doesn't work. I tried the ways of the universe. Ended up with this, ultimately ended up with total mental chaos. And then backing away from that, you get severe depression, severe illness, severe fatigue, severe weakness. And now you're in severe injuries. Got the injuries now, and severe incapacity, and all this severe, you know, doesn't work. These are cheap, fake, wannabe failures. These are just phony wannabe failures, okay? Built on a foundation of desiring success. So, we don't need to keep pursuing these fake, plastic, wannabe failures, fake failures. Who wants fake failures? I want the real thing. I want perfect, absolute, total, complete, perfect failure, incapable of any success. That's where refuge from this universe can be found. Even the most severe mental illnesses are just fake wannabe failures. Paranoia, dissociation, projection, hallucination, all of this fake wannabe failures. That's why there's so much suffering in them. It is mixed with desire. They're based on the desire for success. But there's no suffering in perfect failure at all. There's no possibility of success there. It's just complete refuge. Absolute peace. Absolute peace. Not even a ripple of success. Not even a whiff of success. Success can't even remotely touch us. Just the shadows of a silly dream. The universe is just shadows, empty shadows of a silly, quaint dream. Fake wannabe failure. A dream of fake wannabe failure. Now, you may be feeling this ache, I'm feeling it, but that's okay, it's fine. just have to be a little patient. We're certainly honing in on it now. It's on our radar, to say the least. And so we just have to get used to this. Just used to this. Get used to it. That's all. And pretty soon we'll get impatient and we'll go even farther into it. And yet we are keeping a quick pace here. Absolutely. Absolutely. There are those whose responsibility it is to kind of help out other refugees, you know, as they come in and encourage them. And so that those have to be ready, you know. They have to be ready to help out. Almost in California, we're just about ready now to implement forced vaccinations for everyone. Nobody can get exemptions. that's no bueno at all. Forced vaccinations. Isn't that beautiful? Everyone here will, the parents have no say, your child must be vaccinated, of course. Ultimately, what are they going to put in the vaccinations? Nanotechnology, of course. Next thing you know, it'll be forced chipping of everyone, you see. Lipstick culture. Already, then the healthcare, forced healthcare system, right? Forced healthcare. Everybody has to have healthcare. Take refuge from the universe. The universe is a vicious, vicious beast. Always has been, always will be. We better inoculate ourselves from the universe with perfect failure. Where can we find the vaccination to immunize ourselves from the universe? That's what we need. We need a vaccination for the universal plague. Plagueis universalis. The dreaded universe plague. Line up, get your inoculations, get your vaccinations. Of course, here it's not forced. You see, it's voluntary. If you want to fall ill with the universal plague, then that's your choice. But if you want to get a vaccination, by all means, get a vaccination for the universal plague, the plague that is the universe. Be vaccinated against success. Absolutely be completely vaccinated against success. That's what these great teachers do, the dwelling in the I am-ness, perfect failureness. They're like vaccinations. The more you hang around them, the more you pay attention to them, the more you become immunized from success, the plague of success. So we take our time here, because it's understood that these are shockwaves or reverberating through us, absolutely. If they're reverberating through me, they're probably reverberating through anyone who's paying attention here. I'm just having to let this wow calm down so I can get a second wind here. It's very intense. You know, I've never heard talk like this, ever, in all my lifetime of searching for spiritual help. Never heard talk like this. So this is just the grace of God expressing itself, and I'm hearing it myself, just like you're hearing it. It's just, wow, love it. But it's very potent. Very unequivocal. Very direct. The lipstick culture is becoming absolutely ferocious and virulent. The plague, the universal plague of success, it struck this world. It's the deadliest plague there is. And the symptoms of this dreadful plague are this lipstick culture. Terrible symptoms. So this dreaded plague is upon this world now. And we knew it was coming. I was absolutely warned and told it's coming. That's why I came back in this world to try to help. And it is here. This plague is raging throughout the world right now. Severe, most dreaded plague of all. The most dreaded plague. And so we are absolutely lining up for inoculation shots to that. This is like the inoculation, at least, where you maybe have to, you know, maybe like you get a series of inoculations, like rabies shots. You know, you get what little shot, then a little stronger, a little stronger, a little stronger, a little stronger, a little stronger. So. And eventually we'll reach full immunity. The plague cannot infect us. See, when the wow is off the charts, you don't really say anything. You can't measure it, so what is there to say? You can't conceptualize it. It's gone beyond concepts. The wow is just this feeling like, wow, I've just gone beyond concepts. So why are you in struggle trying to, you know, put it into concepts? That's why I say, don't struggle with the struggle. Let this be your motto. Don't struggle with the struggle. Remind yourself of this. Don't struggle with the struggle. So this terrible plague has struck this planet. But Dr. Jesus has the vaccination for it. And Dr. Jesus has his associates helping out too. We need a lot of inoculation stations in the world. That's why Longchenpa had this Red Cross, like a medic, you know, lifeguard, medic. He's coming in here to help, you know, give inoculations. Absolutely. The doctors are back. The doctors are coming here to fight this deadly plague, this most terrible plague. They'll see us being turned into just playthings of artificial intelligence. This plague of success, this plague of phony failure, this plague, this universal plague, has reached epidemic proportions in this planet. Just like in bubonic plague, you see the lymph nodes turn all dark. Bubos, these swollen lymph nodes, they're all dark. Bubonic plague, the terrible bubonic plague. Well, this plague has symptoms too, and we're seeing those symptoms. The dreadful lipstick culture, putting lipstick on the pig. Lipstick on the pig of success. Dreadful symptoms everywhere here. I mean, really, the Black Death has nothing on this situation now. And this is way more frantic and frightful than the Black Death. The bubonic plague, or the Spanish influenza, bird flu, whatever you want to call it. You know, this is way worse. We're way more frantic. People are saying, "Oh my gosh, what? You know, this is just. Where do I go? What do I do? I don't know what to do. I don't know how to. How do I escape? How do I escape this plague? How do I escape this plague?" So, yeah. So the doctors are working to help us, giving us inoculations. Inoculations are available. Certainly when you get inoculation, you might feel like a reaction to it. So when we get this inoculation here, we're going to feel this wow reaction. This has gone beyond concepts, and this kind of, it, we're not used to going beyond concepts, are we? We're not used to having, we're not used to this perfect failure. We're used to having some success mixed in there, some concepts. But this goes beyond concepts, and so it's a strain on us. We say, whoa, what about success? I have to mix success in there somehow, don't I? No, perfect. We can have perfect failure. Oh wow, I'm so used to mixing in success, you know, and generating concepts, of course. So like, wow, this is really reminds me of something long ago. It seems like a faint dream that I used to have. It reminds me of that. Well, of course, that's reality that we have forgotten when we have dreamed this dream of success. There's a difference to those who've accepted perfect failure. And you can tell, like Ramana Maharshi, for instance, you know, compare Ramana Maharshi to a lot of the spiritual teachers that are in the world today, and you'll recognize a difference. He's certainly one of the top examples that we can give, absolutely. A tremendous inoculator from success. It's quite a rebuke that we don't have such right now here, especially in the Western world, but maybe anywhere. It's quite a rebuke. And we should take it personally, you know, like, wow. You know, we're helping, you know, rebuke this somehow. The world is rebuking this, so we need to certainly repent. Do everything we can to accept this flawless, seamless, perfect failure without any possibility of success. And then we know we're walking with God in perfect holiness. Walking with God in perfect holiness. See, the universe is incapable of recognizing those who have accepted perfect failure. The universe can't recognize them, but we can. You see, we're not the universe. We're actually the children of perfect failure. Absolute, flawless, complete, perfect failure. No trace of success at all. We don't need success. We're already perfect, so we're children of this perfect failure. So we can recognize it, but the universe cannot. Universe being just a silly, wannabe, fake dream of failure. Really, it's a dream of success, trying to masquerade as failure. Says, yeah, we got some failure here too. What do you mean, you got perfect failure? Well, we got failure too. You know? Yeah, we got death, we got sickness, we got all this stuff, we got failure too here. No, it's a dream. It's a dream of success, a crazy, insane dream of success. Trying to pretend that it's, yeah, we're down with failure too. We understand failure too, but we understand both success and failure. We're superior to you. You only got perfect failure. We got this mixture of failure and success. You got just fake failure, phony failure, dream failure. Symbolic failure. It's really a dream of success. Who are you trying to kid, ego? Mixing in this, trying to mix in elements you think that you think represent failure. No, failure is perfect. There's no way to represent perfection. These phony failures that this dream tries to pull up are just ridiculous. Don't bear any resemblance to true failure, perfect failure, not at all. The ego says, look, we have death. And say, what is that? What are you talking about? It has nothing to do with perfect failure. What about this sickness? You know, no, that doesn't have anything to do with perfect failure either. There's no correlation whatsoever. This is a joke. This universe is a joke. No similarities. That's why we're so perplexed. We get perplexed by this universe. What? What are you talking about? Death? What are you talking about? Failure? What is that? It has nothing to do with failure. That's just it's just part of this dream of success you're having, actually. It's just an arrogant definition that has no correlation whatsoever. So, sorry. Ego, you. You're a fake. Ego's a fake. No correlation. No similitude. All this sickness, death, decay. We're being told this has some similitude to perfect failure. It has no similitude. It has no similitude whatsoever. Nothing but a stupid joke. So, you get up in the morning, don't have any work. Uh-oh. Got lemons. What do? You make lemonade. Make lemonade. That's what we're doing. Strong lemonade. Got to put a lot of honey in it. Sweeten it up. Strong lemonade here. Very good. So, super auspicious. What is today? The 20... it's 26. 26, 26, 26, 26. 26 of June 2:15. The plague is advancing upon us. People were falling right and left, all around us. We're seeing evidence that our friends and family and everyone have been infected with this terrible plague, been turned into zombies, carriers of lipstick culture. And so we're saying, wow, I need stronger inoculation, stronger inoculation, stronger inoculation. We have to set up inoculation stations. The universe is trying to inoculate us against perfect failure. And saying, we're going to shoot you full of everything we can possibly think of to prevent you from ever choosing perfect failure. They'll throw every bit of nanotechnology they can, snipping away at your genes, you know, trying to prevent choosing perfect failure. But they cannot accomplish this at all. Actually, it's all phony. It's all fake. See, time, space, process, and form, those are all dreams of success. Dreams that we can successfully change reality. But where I am, perfect failure. There is no success at all. Not even a trace of it. In the realm of perfect failure, there's no time, space, process, or form. Such a dream does not even touch this realm. I am perfect failure, incapable of success. I am perfect failure, incapable of success. I am perfect failure, incapable of success. You see, when we're doing this, we don't need it. We don't need all the music, the flowers, you know, the decorations, the ornamentation, the pageantry. We don't need that. We don't need it. This is way too attractive to us beyond those other things. Forget that stuff. It's like, wow. This is super attractive. perfect failure is super attractive. There isn't enough lipstick to put on any pig to make it even remotely as attractive as perfect failure. You can't dress up the pig of success to be even remotely as attractive as pure failure. Perfect failure. Pure failure. I embrace pure failure. I embrace pure failure. Perfect failure. I'm incapable of success. I embrace pure failure. Lipstick culture thinks it's their duty to infect everybody with the virus of success, to inject them again and again and again and again and again with this horrible virus, which is what's going on in the world right now, this horrible plague. Don't think that Jesus isn't aware of it. Why would he bring in A Course in Miracles to the world, make it available to us, and then... Hey. Okay, well, it's merely a text. From who? I don't know. Someone's frantic about success. They say, I'm not being successful. Can you please help me be successful? Yeah. I'm trying to do everything I possibly can do to be successful, but I'm not being successful. Can you please help me be successful? So at least we have to continue for a moment to pretend a little bit, but the inoculation is working, absolutely. I am perfect failure. I am pure failure. I am incapable of success. What a beautiful inoculation. What an attractive inoculation. Watching the residue of success here being thrown into the garbage truck. That's the world's most beautiful sound. Someone's taking your trash away. I say, oh, great. They didn't forget me. They didn't pass me by. That's our greatest fear, isn't it? They don't pick up our garbage. That and the plumbing is blocked up. Those are two of our greatest fears, for sure. That's all that separates us from cavemen, you know. So, this is all very stunning, but we're ready for it, absolutely. Expect it. We've been going in this direction. We've been working, and now we're just simply continuing, you know, on the next leg of the hike. Yeah, that's where we're at. Not a big surprise. I am perfect failure. I am pure failure. I am pure failure. Flawless. I am pure, flawless failure. Incapable of any success whatsoever. The vast ocean of perfect, pure failure, there's not a single ripple upon it of any success. It's absolutely still. Absolutely calm. Now, of course, these assertions are sending shockwaves through the psyche. It's like, ah, because deep down we know this is effective inoculation. This is effective refuge from the universe. People try to have success. I'm failing at success. Can you help me out? You look like you're good at success. I get this a lot, you know. This is just a tactic. This is something like the lipstick culture has used for a long time. It's like, young man, you look like you're very successful, young man. I'm having a little trouble with success. Could you help me with success here? No, I'm a perfect failure. No, you don't look like a perfect failure to me. Oh, yes, I am. I'm a perfect failure. I'm an immaculate, pure, perfect failure. I'm immaculate, pure, perfect failure. I'm the antivirus, you know. It inoculates from the virus of failure. Of success, the virus of success. It's like every morning we got to get up and say, okay, I need to be inoculated some more intensely to prevent this plague, universal plague, success plague from infecting me and pulling me down into hideous faux failures like death and sickness and misery and madness and acting out and paranoia and attack and all this terrible victimization dance and all this stuff. It's a terrible plague of success. I need to be inoculated. Be inoculated from the terrible virus of success, the terrible plague. Take refuge in pure, perfect failure. Perfect failure. Flawless, perfect failure. It's so perfect, it's just shining and shining and shining and shining in its perfection, in its holiness, in its completeness, in its complete sanctity. Pure failure, total sanctity. Untouched, pristine, immaculate. Inherently immaculate, without us having to do anything. Without us having to get rid of any success, shed any success. There's no success there at all. So we don't need to. We just take refuge in it. And we don't have to fight off success and, oh, I gotta sweep out success, the dust of success, I need to sweep that away. There's no even dust of success there. The dust of success doesn't fall there at all. I would say the Silicon Valley is like ground zero for the plague, this awful plague of success. That's why this doctor's been here, you know, researching this. It's like, wow, there's some hideous plague that's broken out on the planet. Let's go to ground zero and figure out, you know, what we can do about this. Absolutely. Hideous universal success plague. That which makes us go, uh-oh. We're really in trouble now. Where do we flee from this? We must flee from this. The elites are fleeing, you know, New Zealand, fleeing to underground bunkers. Everybody's saying, well, I need to find a sanctuary. Where? Find sanctuary in pure, perfect failure. Pure, perfect failure. Shining perfection. Absolutely, immaculately pure failure. Absolute, complete, total, immaculate, perfect, flawless failure without any trace or capability of success whatsoever. Not even a speck of success is ever found there. And since it never falls there, there's no need to maintain or dust and, you know, keep it clean. It's always clean from success. Totally clean. No maintenance required. If you're not severely infected by this plague, you can't even find work anymore. You know, you're not working on success enough. So also, of course, take refuge in the realm of absolute, perfect, flawless, pure failure. Not a trace of success there. Take refuge there. And this will sustain you. You'll feel absolutely welcome there. You'll recognize this is home. This is truly the sanctuary that I've been searching for. This is the peace that I've been searching for. This is the safety I've been searching for. I walk with God in perfect holiness. So taking sanctuary is a serious situation. You have to be serious about it. You have to be dedicated about it. You don't want to get this, be infected by this dreadful plague, dreadful universal success plague. You don't want to be a plaything of robots. What a joke the universe really is. What a joke. So be serious and take refuge. Keep practicing at it. Stay intent upon it. Don't let the roots of body thoughts grow. Don't let the roots of success grow. Don't fall for any fake failures either. The fake failure of death. Don't fall for that scam. Fake failure of disease, don't fall for that scam. Fake failure of aging, don't fall for that scam. Fake failure of sickness, incapacity, don't fall for any of those scams. Decay. We know those are all fake. With no similitude whatsoever to true failure. Perfect failure. And again, we're speaking conceptually, of course. When in Rome, do as Romans do. And as long as we're dreaming, we're going to be speaking in the lingua franca of the dream. So whenever we start conceptualizing, trying to conceptualize failure, say, that's trying to be successful. No, I'm absolute perfect failure. There's no conceptualization of that. I'm absolute perfect failure. I don't need the fake failure of poverty, the fake failure of misery, all these fake delusional failures really based on a dream of success. I don't need any of those. I'll settle for the neutrality of a light body. Neither failure nor success, neither trying to be one of them. Just be a light body, that's all. as a placeholder within the dream. We want to keep at least a placeholder within the dream for now, so let's be a light body. And let's just be a light body, that's fine. It's about an hour and a half. Yeah, that's probably enough for these videos. This inoculation is so intense. Maybe we do more of them, but not quite as long. Or seems to work out. But again, a most auspicious day. It's like it's coming into focus now. And we're just saying, yes, 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 great, pure, perfect failure, wonderful. Wow. Let me sit on the shores of that ocean. Let's have a little campfire there. Terrific. All right, full stop in the wow. Don't conceptualize the wow. Don't conceptualize at all. Just realize that you've gone beyond conceptions here and just let it be. All right, we're going to end this one now. Very great. Continue, full stop in the wow. Just let this sink in and we'll go from there. Very great. That's